Welcome to Plyerotech YouTube channel. If you not subscribe, please subscribe, like, share and comments, and don't forget to click the bell icon. If you click the bell icon, you will get notification when I post new video. Okay, today we are going to talk about airplanes major components and main control surfaces. One of the first things you like to notice when you begin working on aircraft is widely variety of aeroplane styles and designs. At the first time, you may think that aeroplanes look quite different from one another, but you will find that their major components are quite similar. So today we are going to talk about major similar component of the aeroplane. Okay, now let's see what are the major components of the aeroplane. So main body of the aeroplane. Main body of the aeroplane is called fuselage, the main body. So this is the main body of the aeroplane is called fuselage. And then this part, this component of the aeroplane, you can see left side and right side of both part is there is called wings. Wings is attached to the fuselage. Then tail section of the fuselage is called, this section is called empennage. Empennage consists of two parts. Horizontal part is called horizontal stabilizer, this part, and the vertical part is called vertical stabilizer or pin. Now you know major components of the aeroplane. This is called fuselage, this is called wings, and this area is called tail section or empennage. Empennage consists of two parts. This is vertical stabilizer or tail pin, and this is horizontal stabilizer. Okay, now let's talk about fuselage. What is the fuselage? The fuselage serves several functions besides being a common attachment point for the other major components. It provides space for cockpit where a flight crew operates the aircraft, and a cabin area for passengers or cargo. Aircraft is meant to carry passengers. The cabin is specially equipped with sheets, galleys, and lavatories. In this configuration, cargo and baggage are placed in a dedicated cargo area or pit in the lower part of the fuselage. And this fuselage is providing attachment point for other major components. Okay, so this wing and empennage attached to the fuselage. This wing is attached to the fuselage, and empennage and or tail section, all horizontal stabilizer, vertical stabilizer, all attached to the fuselage. Okay, now let's see about the wing. What is the wing? The wings have two types of control surfaces attached to the rear or trailing edges. They are called as aileron and flaps. Ailerons extend from about midpoint of the wing outwards to the tip. Ailerons move opposite directions. when one aileron goes up, the other goes down. This is called leading edge and this is called trailing edge. One aileron is at the corner, one side, and other is called aileron, and other one is other side. So both the side, two ailerons are there at the outboard of the wing. These ailerons pilot can control from the cockpit with a control column, and it is connected with the support of cable and pulleys, and they can move like this, and ailerons will go up one side and other side will be down. Here you can see the pulleys and cables routing to the aileron. If this ailerons go up, so this one will go down. So it can control the aircraft rolling movement. This rolling movement is like this, so aileron is controlling this movement. So other control surface is called flaps. Flaps extend outward from the fuselage to the midpoint of the each wing. They always move in the same direction. If one flap is down, the other one is down. The flaps are used to increase the lift of the wing. That means if flap is down, the area of the wing is increasing. Then if the area increase, the lift will be increased. Movement of the flaps controlled by pilot in the cockpit. Pilot will use a flap control lever to increase flap angle to provide more lift. These flaps using only takeoff and landing to increase the lift. Wind air blows around the wings of an airplane, it generates a force called lift that helps the airplane fly. The wings generate to take maximum advantage of this force. So the flaps increase the area of the wing and it generates more lift when aircraft is landing and take off. On this small aircraft having aileron and flap only on the wing. But some larger aircraft employ spoilers on the top of the wing to disturb the airflow and reduce lift. And these all small aircraft, all control surfaces control with the support of pulleys and cables. Small aircraft, all control surfaces are attached to the cable mechanism with the control column in the cockpit. But large modern passenger aircraft control system is called fly-by-wire system. That means all pilots control stick movement transmitting electrically to the hydraulic system, and it will operate hydraulic actuators with the control surfaces. So fly-by-wire system you can learn later. Okay, now let's talk about impenage. The impenage consists of two parts, horizontal stabilizer and vertical stabilizer or pin. Two surfaces are stationary and help to maintain a straight path through the air of the airplane. This is vertical stabilizer and the rudder is attached to the back of the vertical stabilizer to move the airplane's nose left and right. Left and right by the pilots moving the rudder pedals on the below of the pilot seat. He can move forward, back, and then the movement transmitting to the rudder with the control cables. So rudder is moving side to side, left or right, and aircraft move like this. This is called yawing movement. If pilot need to turn the aircraft, he will move the rudder. Actually, the rudder is used in combination with ailerons during flight to initiate a turn. Okay, now let's see about the horizontal stabilizer. The elevator is attached to the back of the horizontal stabilizer. During flight, the elevator is used to move nose up and down to direct the airplane to desired altitude or height above the ground. So pilot can control column forward, back, and it will transmit the movement with the control cables to the elevator. So then the aircraft will move like this, up and down mover. So it is called pitching movement. You know already what are the control surfaces: aileron, flap, aileron, rudder, elevator. This type of small aircrafts using control cable mechanism to control all the control surfaces. But large modern passenger aircraft mostly using a fly-by-wire control system. Okay, now you know all the major component of the airplane and main control surfaces. Okay, main body of the aeroplane is called, this is called fuselage. This part of the airplane is called wing. This is the one generating lift for the aircraft to fly. And this one is called empennage. Empennage or tail section is consists of two parts, horizontal stabilizer and vertical stabilizer and rudder and elevator and then ailerons, this ailerons, flaps, right. Now you know already the major component of the airplane and main control surfaces of the airplane. So please subscribe my YouTube channel, like, share and click the bell icon and wait for next video.